टुडेज रेसिपी इज अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ लड्डू, वीट फ्लावर लड्डू और आटे के लड्डू. नाउ दे हैव अ स्पेशल क्रंची इंग्रेडिएंट इनसाइड देम एंड द सीक्रेट इंग्रेडिएंट दैट यू विल सून कम टू नो. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इट इमिटेट्स एडिबल गम और गोंद एंड सो दीज आर ऑफन रिफर टू एज फेक गोंद के लड्डू. सो फर्स्ट लेट अस स्टार्ट विद अ लुक एट द इंग्रेडिएंट्स नीडेड फॉर वीट फ्लावर लड्डू.
मीडियम थिक पोहा और फ्लैटेंड राइस फ्लेक्स हाफ अ कप, वीट फ्लावर और आटा 1.5 कप्स, ड्राई ग्रेटेड कोकोनट 1/4 ऑफ अ कप, पाउडर्ड शुगर 1 कप, पॉपी सीड्स 2 टेबलस्पून्स, क्लैरिफाइड बटर और घी हाफ अ कप एंड कार्डमम पाउडर अकॉर्डिंग टू टेस्ट. We are going to start with dry roasting the grated coconut. When it is evenly brown in color, transfer it to another bowl where we are going to mix all the ingredients together. Now in the same pan, we will roast the poppy seeds till they are also reddish brown in color. And then reduce the heat to low and transfer these to the same mixing bowl. Now heat the clarified butter.
Now let us try by adding a single flake of poha to check the temperature. It should sizzle and quickly rise to the surface. That means the correct temperature has been reached. So now let us add all the poha. Make sure that the heat is on low and keep stirring continuously for about a minute till all the poha puffs up and gets nicely fried so that it is crunchy even from the inside.
So now you know the secret ingredient. It is the poha or the rice flake that gives these laddus a special crunch.
Now after frying them for about a minute, we are going to drain out the excess ghee and remove them in a separate bowl or plate. Now let us keep this poha aside for some time. Now to the same ghee that has been left after frying the poha, add the wheat flour, roast the wheat flour
till it becomes darker in color. Now allow the wheat flour to cool down till it is cool enough to touch with your hands. Now to this mixing bowl which has the roasted poppy seeds and the grated coconut, we are going to add the powdered sugar. Mix them together. When the wheat flour becomes easy enough to touch with your hands, transfer it to the mixing bowl.
Now to this also add all the fried poha.
Now mix it together nicely. Use a kneading action so that this becomes really soft, just like a dough, and you are able to shape it into laddus. If you think that the mixture is little dry and it's not binding together to make laddus, then you can try adding little ghee to it. Just add very little, you won't have to add too much, maybe a spoonful, and then knead again nicely. A nice kneading also helps to make the dough softer.
Now this has become soft enough, it can be easily rolled into laddus.
Add little cardamom powder according to your liking. Mix again. Now take a small portion at a time and make small round laddus with it. Repeat with the rest of the mixture and your delicious wheat flour laddus will be ready. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy making these delicious laddus at home. Please remember to post any questions or comments on my website at uma.kitchen or on my YouTube channel at Uma's Kitchen, Indian Vegetarian Cooking Recipes. Thank you.